session. I am joined by the beautiful Charlotte, and we are going to be doing a very relaxing facial for her. I'm going to be using an oil cleanser. I have used this one before, and it is the Elemis cleansing balm. And I've just warmed that up in my hands. Placing it onto dry skin tonight and just massaging it into the skin. Charlotte has beautiful skin, and she doesn't suffer with breakouts or oily skin, so it is okay to introduce an oil. And this will just break down any makeup or debris that she has on her face. It is a really good product to use as a first cleanse, and it smells really nice as well. Again, it is quite a potent lavender smell, but if you do enjoy that kind of smell, then you would really like this product. I'm just going to grab my mitts, and they are coming out of the steamer. So what I will do is place Charlotte's hair up. And I will place them either side of her to, number one, cool down a little bit, and number two, open up her pores as well. I have also added some lavender essential oil to the water. For the second cleanse, I'm going to use the Sukin Foaming Facial Cleanser, and this has some really good properties within it. It has green tea, witch hazel and chamomile, and they're all very calming on the skin. just add a little bit of water to help it foam. We'll just gently remove that as well. The mitts have cooled down a little bit now, so it's okay to place directly onto the skin. I'm now going to do a detoxifying mask for Charlotte, and this one is called the Botanic Australia Charcoal Face Mask. This is a really light mask to use, and it dries quite quickly as well, which I find to be quite beneficial because I don't really like to use the ones that take a good 20 minutes to dry. So this one has activated charcoal and it is well known for its detoxifying properties. So I'm just going to take a fan brush and apply that onto Charlotte's face. I'll just place it on the back of my hand. And you only need a very light layer of this. So this will be left on for 5 to 10 minutes, and whilst that is drying and taking effect, I'm going to give Charlotte a gentle scalp massage and also incorporate the neck. alternate side. Place Charlotte's face forward again. remove the facial mask now. So, because we have used a detoxifying mask, we are going to want to replenish the skin. So, I'm now going to do a very gentle facial massage with some oil. And we have to be careful with what oils we're using on the skin. A lot of oils can be pore clogging, so we want one which is more non-comedogenic. There are an array of these oils out there, and they are not extremely pricey, but it's probably a good idea just to do research on what oils will be beneficial for the face and what oils are actually not going to help you at all. So today we are using a cold pressed rosehip oil, and it does have omega-3 within it as well, and that is obviously a fatty acid, and that can be very beneficial for the skin. So I'm just going to take my oil and I'm not going to use too much. We will be using the Jade roller, and that's probably best to not have too much slip on the skin when we use that. And I'm just tracing from the centre of Charlotte's face down to the bottom of the ears, and this is where the lymphatic drainage system is. It's always good to follow the path of outwards on the face because it helps stimulate the lymph nodes and helps rid your body of toxins. You also have two pressure points on either side of the bottom of the nose, and we can just trace the bone under the eye. and across the cheekbone as well. And again, there are some pressure points here, and just even simply pressing down very lightly on them can help stimulate them. So now that Charlotte's skin has been nicely warmed up with the oil, we are going to go on and use a jade roller. And this is a really nice tool for the face. You can get cheaper ones, but they probably will not be a jade stone, it will just be jade particles, so to be careful when you are buying them. And it makes a nice squeaky noise when we use it as well, and it is a stone that stays naturally cold, so it feels very pleasant on the skin, and it can help with muscular tension, it can close pores up, and it just feels really nice. So I'll start on Charlotte's chin and jawline. If you grind your teeth or have any problems with stress in your jaw, it can be very beneficial. Thank you. usually do get two sides to a jade roller. The smaller side is usually for the eyes and the contours around the eyes and also the nose area. And again, it can feel really nice on the under eye. But we do have to apply less pressure for around the eye area. So that has helped the remainder of the oil sink into Charlotte's skin. I'm going to finish with a very light moisturiser just to lock all of the products in. And I'm using the Kaizo moisturiser. It has balm, mint and cotton in it and it smells really, really nice. Charlotte's skin looks absolutely glowing right now. I hope you have enjoyed this facial. I have very much enjoyed filming it. Charlotte, thank you so very much for having me on your channel.
Thank you.
very much does deserve it. And please do go and have a look at my other facials if you'd like. But apart from that, please take